including electricity and circuits. All of these things and more are a regular part of the curriculum with STEM, which stands for science.
Protects the brain and why? School is what protects the brain, and school is 22% bone.
Okay, now how are you finding your information?
Looking it up online.
Then you're going to go up, then right, then up, then right.
These students are doing something not always found in your typical elementary school class.
Working on coding. That may not be something you would have in a traditional fifth grade class, but our kids have those exposures.
Because they attend Bluford Academy, which offers a magnet program in science, technology, engineering, and math, or STEM. It's also one of 54 magnet programs in Guilford County schools now accepting applications.
It's an exciting time of the year. Throughout the school year, we have parents who talk about wanting to attend our school, that this is that opportunity when they get to apply.
Families need to head online to apply. A lottery system determines how students are placed in the programs, which span the sciences, language, as well as performing and visual arts.
There are some students who are really looking for areas of special interest, perhaps, or a different type of learning environment. And these magnet programs offer some of those differences.
An official said being in a magnet program can have positive ripple effects.
If they have something that they're really interested in, then they're able to focus and hold out for the long haul. So they are in it. If their interest is being fed, then they're going to be stronger in all of the academic areas.
Which can then have an impact beyond school walls.
Our goal is to better prepare our children to be successful outside of this world so they can eventually give back to the community what they have learned through our public schools.
A learning experience specialized in one area, but having benefits across many. In Greensboro, Amara Amokwe, Time Warner Cable News.
A Guilford County school contacted us about their good news, and I think you're going to like this one, Eric.
Ooh.
You know, bow ties. Yeah.
I hear they're making a comeback,
they
right?
They are, and they look fabulous. Guys are sporting them a lot lately.
I'm going to have to try it.
Yeah.
Ed did it a couple weekends ago.
He did, and he looked great.
It was awesome there. But for students at Bluford STEM Academy, they're more than a fashion statement here.
They're a life statement, thanks to a donation from a man who's volunteered there for 16 years. Take a look.
No jumping on what?
Pig.
Jumping on what?
Pig.
Jumping on what?
Every week.
You don't jump on your bed at home, do you? Ooh.
Dedicated volunteer Larry Haywood helps the students at Bluford STEM Academy.
In his bedroom near the top floor of a tall apartment building, Walter was getting ready for bed.
He wears his bow tie on Mondays, and the boys wear theirs.
Ooh-wee. Monday is a power day of encouragement. The bow ties represent encouragement. The students are supposed to encourage themselves as well as others.
Haywood's support goes even farther than that. Every young man in the school has a bow tie thanks to a gift from Haywood's church.
We were able to bring approximately 200 bow ties in this school for the young men, but then the young ladies wanted them.
In fact, it's turned into something special for the girls.
Some pearls.
As Anaya mentioned, the girls wear pearls and the bow ties for the guys start the school week each week and every Empowerment Monday.
There's a little bit more of a step, a little sharpness to their step.
The bow tie sent students' confidence to the moon.
It makes me feel like I can do anything.
Usually people will make fun of them about what they wear and stuff, but when they have on their bow ties, they give them compliments.
So while the learning goes on in the classroom,
say go to sleep.
Go to sleep.
All right.
Kids are picking up on another lesson about life.
Their confidence should be built up. And along with the encouragement, that's the most important thing.
And the kids love it. I mean, you can see it on their faces, right? The impact that these bow ties make. Here's the extra special part of this, Eric. You're going to love this. Not only is Bluford STEM Academy doing it, but it's spreading to other Guilford County schools. So Sumner Elementary School, the kids there are going to start wearing bow ties and pearls coming
up
soon.
That's a great idea.
Yeah.
Makes them feel grown up. And I guarantee you that subconsciously that makes them feel more like a grown up and they want to act more like. You know what I mean?
Right.
I bet it might affect behavior.
And it's a program where every student has one. So it's not like, oh, I have one. You
That's
don't.
Right.
You know, everyone can feel the same. Everyone can feel important and smart.
Then it becomes a contest of who has the coolest,
oh,
right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what happens after that.
This is a GCS News Break.
Bluford has served our community for so long and in such great ways that we're so delighted that we're going to be able to update some of these facilities and bring some new facilities in place that's going to make this even a better place to go to school.
Bluford STEM Academy welcomed folks back to the schoolyard for a groundbreaking ceremony. As part of the 2008 school bond project, Guilford County Schools continues to update and upgrade buildings across the county. With construction already underway, Bluford will get a new multi-purpose room as well as electrical and plumbing upgrades throughout the entire building.
There are so many components of this school that are the originals. I would be glad to take you on a tour of the cafeteria that's the absolute original. Some of the toilet features are the original. So yes, we are very excited about the upgrades.
The concert band entertains the people who've come to break ground at High Point Central High School. With a growing student population of more than 1,400, the school is happy to be getting a new cafeteria building that will double the size of the old one. Construction is expected to be complete in January of 2017.
This is super exciting for High Point Central and the community. It is a space that is going to be an open space, and we will use it for much more than just the cafeteria during lunchtime.
The third groundbreaking in April comes courtesy of Hunter Elementary. Hunter is getting an entirely new school. The current building opened way back in 1929. Demolition will begin on it after the new school opens around March or April of 2017.
As you can see, the construction is well underway, and right now the dirt and the footings and all of the iron stakes that you see are only going to be there for just a little while, but soon those hallways in our new building will be filled with children learning, teachers teaching, and our community coming out to celebrate on a daily basis all of the wonderful work that's taking place in our classrooms.
This has been a GCS News Break. GCS, yes. At Bluford STEM Academy, we meet each child where they are and develop them into well-rounded individuals, ready for college, career, and life. Our school is a growth experience for children, parents, and our community. Together, we shape a better future for your child and community. The excellent teachers within our school work with parents, businesses, and colleges to deliver relevant learning that links a child's interest and skills with the future economy of our community and the world. Your child gains the full package for success: knowledge, know-how, service, confidence, and character. We do more than prepare each child for college and career training. We make sure each graduate can pay for a college education and training for a career. With Say Yes to Education Guilford, every eligible public school graduate can receive a last dollar tuition scholarship so they can afford to complete a college degree or post-secondary certificate. Parents, children, educators, and business leaders are saying GCS, yes. Together, we go from classroom to college and career.
Second language. Kids have a lot of different interests, and in Guilford County, there are several schools to help kids sharpen those special skills. Debrell Teray is the executive director for the Academically Gifted for Guilford County Schools. We also have students and administrators from Bluford STEM Academy. Good morning.
Good morning.
And a very special robot. We'll get to him, Mr. Robot, in just a few minutes. Thank you for looking my way. So, Debrell, we'll start with you. There are 46 different programs and even more choices that parents can choose from. Go over some of them for us this morning.
Well, so we have some main themes, and some of those themes go from kindergarten all the way through 12th grade. We have science and technology, which we have some representatives here today. We also have the performing and visual arts, international baccalaureate, which is a high academic standards type thing. We also have Spanish immersion, for example, that goes across the grades.
Yeah, so this fair, for lack of a better term, is a place where people can really talk to administrators, students, staff about the options available.
Absolutely. It's a one-stop shop. This is the opportunity to come and meet with anyone and everyone and to find out maybe some topics of interest, but also some that you weren't aware of and maybe your child might be interested in.
All right, speaking of the kids, I'm going to slide over here and talk to some of them. What's your name and what do you want to be when you get older?
My name is KJ, and I want to be a game designer when I grow up.
And so why do you like going to Bluford STEM Academy?
I go into Bluford because we get to do, like, the hands-on experiments, and I have a great teacher.
Oh, that's awesome. Can I move over so I can talk to one of your classmates here? What's your name?
Anaya.
Anaya, why do you like going to Bluford STEM Academy?
I like going to Bluford because they make sure we learn, and we still get to learn and have fun at the same time.
Awesome. Tell me who this is next to you.
Mr. Robot.
And what does Mr. Robot do?
Move and communicate.
All right, let's see what you can make him do. Whoa! And he laughed a little bit too. Thank you, Mr. Robot. And so do you think that if you didn't go to Bluford STEM, you wouldn't learn all this cool stuff?
No.
That's awesome. They programmed this robot, which is pretty awesome. So, and I have a minute just to talk to you really quickly? Why would you say that this is a good opportunity for kids to go to Bluford STEM?
I think the best thing about Bluford STEM Academy is we have passion for making sure our students are academically prepared. We provide them with experiences preparing them for science, technology, engineering, mathematics. We believe that every child can achieve, and we just love to see their smiles and enjoy the opportunities to expose them to these wonderful experiences. We're working on expanding our Lego opportunities for kids. We're doing engineering day during the school day, so we're really looking at beyond a test score, that there's intellect that we can really hone in on, and that's what we do at Bluford STEM Academy.
I love it. And so there are so many options available for kids out there, and you can learn about all of them this weekend. It is the Choice Fair. It is on Saturday the 21st from 9:30 to 12:30 at the Greensboro Coliseum Special Events Center. All this information, if you missed any of the details, is on our website, WFMYnews2.com. Goodbye, Mr. Robot. Smart, and they are great dancers. Check them out. They couldn't wait to show us their awesome moves.
Today, the message that Bluford STEM Academy students got was that you have to read in order to succeed. I think it's easy to get them hooked on reading because they still have that wonderful imagination, their creativity. They love to read, and I think that the words in the book allow them to tap into that creative side and imagine and dream about opportunities. There was a great opportunity.